The investigation continues into the private life of Cesar Altieri Sayoc Jr., the suspect behind the series of mailed pipe bombs targeted at Democratic leaders and other high-profile personalities. Now, over the weekend, several news agencies spoke to relatives of the Filipino-American accused of the crimes.
So what do we know so far about the man being accused of domestic terrorism? We have ABS-CBN correspondent TJ Minotto and New York correspondent Don Tagala to break down these developments. We start with TJ, who's been tracking the story over the weekend. TJ?
Ginger, Romel, it's been 3 days since the arrest of the suspect behind the pipe bombs intended for Democratic personalities, including former U.S. Presidents Clinton and Obama. Cesar Altieri Sayoc Jr. allegedly sent the letter pipe bombs through postal mail and were intercepted by authorities and Secret Service. Now, amongst the many details that were revealed about Sayoc in a media frenzy weekend is his ethnicity. As it turns out, Sayoc is a Filipino-Italian.
Shortly after he was arrested on Friday, the frenzy began as what to ethnicity Cesar Sayoc Jr. belonged to. Thanks to his strangely worded but detailed description in his LinkedIn profile, clues were strong that he was of Filipino descent after a claim that he is a grandson of Baltazar Zook Sayoc, who had a big part of the proliferation of the martial art known as Sayoc Kali. Several news agencies have come out with reports that have called him out as Filipino. The first of which last Friday was from Newsweek, who had interviewed a cousin of Sayoc who opted to remain anonymous. The cousin shared the family's shock that Sayoc was being accused of domestic terrorism. That cousin confirmed that Sayoc was half Filipino, but he did fall out of favor from the family and he was acting erratic and was told not to come around anymore. The Associated Press also found a relative, Lenny Altieri, who shared that they knew him as a lunatic and a loner. Altieri confirmed as well that Sayoc had been a male stripper and that his biological father was Filipino, but his parents split when he was young. And the most revealing developments were reported by the New York Times on Sunday, as they got an interview with Sayoc's sister, Tina Villasana. Tina was thankful her brother has not hurt anybody. Through the family's lawyer, Ronald Lowy, they made an appeal to Sayoc to accept mental health care and hire a proficient lawyer to represent him. They even sent the message via a handwritten card delivered by Mr. Lowy at the detention center. But in the end, the guards at the detention center turned away Mr. Lowy and he was not able to deliver that handwritten letter.
Ginger, Romel, if convicted, Sayoc could be sentenced to a maximum of 48 years. He was held today at a hearing, and he did have no bail set for him. And the next hearing will be on Friday, still in Miami. Ginger, Romel?
Thank you, TJ. He will be back to tell us about Pinoy reactions to this story. Meanwhile, the relatives of Baltazar Zook Sayoc, who Cesar Jr. claims is his grandfather, made a bold statement saying that they have no knowledge of him.
We move over to Don Tagala, who now joins us from New York to talk about the formal statement of the martial arts organization.
On the same day of his arrest, Cesar Sayoc's white van was covered with a blue tarp. But what was underneath the tarp caught the attention of some photographers. From pro-Trump stickers to pictures of targeted Democrats with crosshairs on their faces and a sticker with Seminole flag that reads, Native Americans for Trump. But the Seminole tribe immediately denied Sayoc's membership in the prominent Native American tribe. One of the first articles that claimed Sayoc's heritage was Heavy.com's 5 Fast Facts You Need to Know About Cesar Sayoc. Number 2 says, Sayoc is a registered Republican. He boasted that his family was involved in fighting the Communist Party in the Philippines. More details about the 56-year-old failed bomber came out. His love for bodybuilding and supposed training in Sayoc Kali mixed martial arts was found on his LinkedIn profile. He also claimed that he belonged to the Sayoc family and that Baltazar Zook Sayoc was his grandfather, who he also claimed built all hospitals in the Philippines. But Rafael Kayanan, a Sayoc Kali master in Pleasantville, New York, told ABS-CBN News that Cesar Sayoc is not someone who trained Sayoc Kali, and no instructor or student of Kayanan knew him. Kayanan said the Sayoc family of Pennsylvania also stated that Baltazar Zook Sayoc is not Cesar's grandfather. He is the brother of Cesar's biological father, Cesar P. Sayoc, making Baltazar his uncle, not only condemning his actions, but stating clearly and confirming that his father was Cesar P. Sayoc and that he has no affiliation with Sayoc Kali. Tess Sayoc, the head of Sayoc Kali in Pennsylvania, also confirmed these relationships, being the widow of Christopher Sayoc Sr., the son of Baltazar. Cesar Sayoc may have claimed White as his race on a 1991 felony record in Florida, or even claimed that he is a member of the Seminole tribe. But one thing is clear though, he is a member of the Sayoc family. He is of Filipino descent. Back to you at the studio.
All right, thank you, Don Tagada. Let's bring back TJ to help us break down these developments. TJ, we heard from your story about the relatives that news organizations spoke to over the weekend. We also heard Don's story just now about the Sayoc Kali statement. What can we make about, or what can we make from this statement from Sayoc Kali?
Well, Ginger, we have to understand that the Sayoc Kali organization, this is a business, and they're running their business. Their martial art has been around for quite some time now. They need to do what they can to protect it, especially if they want to distance themselves from any accusation or allegation from Sayoc Jr. that he was a part of them or that he is directly related to them. So it's not a matter of disclaiming that he is Filipino or not. From what observers are seeing, this is more of a business move that they have to make it clear that they have never had any involvement with him, nor has he had involvement with their martial arts school, and that they want to make sure that this is not mixed up and it won't affect them going on to the future.
Right, TJ. For sure, the Filipino communities here and back home have been up to speed with these developments. How have they been reacting to the revelations that Sayoc is indeed Filipino?
You know what, Ramel? We've been scouring the internet the last 3-4 days, and since it popped out on Friday, every time you search for Sayoc and Filipino, whether on Facebook or on Twitter, you do see some Filipino reactions once in a while outside of the American speculation and the news agencies tweeting their posts. When you catch the Filipinos, they are in shock. They are shocked. They are ashamed of what's happening. It's something obviously they're not proud of. Now, I spoke to a Filipino as well in Miami, Florida, who's lived there for quite some time, Ray Lazaro, who's been a resident in Miami for quite some time. He was there as early back as when the Cunanan case happened during that murder back then. And he said that over the weekend, the chatter has been low about Sayoc Jr. And he suspects that most likely one of two things, that he does actually look white in his photos. And secondly, is that he wasn't actually able to harm anybody as compared to what happened with Cunanan. So I guess for that, the sentiment in Miami, it's been okay. But online, Filipinos are quite ashamed and shocked.
Well, speaking of some of that shock, we might imagine that there was quite a bit of shock from the social media organizations. You know, Tej, it was clear that Sayoc was very active on Twitter and Facebook, to the point he was even making threats online to some of his targets. I imagine maybe they're amongst the people who are shocked as well that this really actually turned out to materialize. Did that go unnoticed? Did they take any action before this all unraveled?
Well, actually, Twitter had received a complaint before from a certain Rochelle Ritchie. She complained about a threat. Twitter did not do anything about it. They came out with a statement apologizing and saying that they were wrong doing that and they will be better moving forward. Ginger Ramel.
All right. Thank you very much. TJ Manotok there with a very comprehensive wrap of this weekend's developments on the Cesar Sayoc case. I'm sure we'll hear and continue more from TJ throughout the week.
Absolutely.